Hi guys, let's just wait till everyone is here for 1-2 minutes. Fan, Hiral, you can mute your audio. For the ones whose this is the first class for you, you can just on your video and mute your audio. Ayan, are you here?
Yes, sir. Let me know when everyone will be here.
Yes, I think there are 17 people now here. Just wait for 10 seconds more. So guys, I saw the work you all have done and I'm very happy that with this time you are still working so much, and I saw all the images and everything. I shared the other group and other students' work also on your group so that you can see each other's work. But I'm really happy you have really explored newspaper. So today's session will be taken by our expert, which is Ayan sir. He will tell you about his experience of NIFT. He will give you a few techniques or to, you know, attempt a question or how to start attempting a question. And then in the end, I'll give you a homework where I'll show you a few sample images and things of how to do it. Okay, guys. So Ayan, I think, 1 second, you can start the session now.
Yeah, just 1 second.
Yes. Binita, Vishal, can you switch off your audio? Can you mute yourself? Yashasvi, can you mute yourself? Yes.
Well, Rimji ma'am.
Yes.
Yeah, I think even you can mute the people if their audio is not mute.
Yeah, that's what
I can unmute if they need it. Everybody, please unmute your video or mute your audio. Make sure your video is on. And the people who are having a first class, I would like here to give you the intro. The now, today is like, you know, there is a feedback session that will be continued by the Ayan sir. Ayan sir is an alumni of NIFT Bangalore 2012 batch, that was Product and Lifestyle Accessories, and the 2016 batch IIT Bombay. He has done the master from IIT Bombay, IDC. IDC is the design department in IIT Bombay. So he'll be giving you the ideas about, like, you know, what you have done in few classes, how you need to take place, like, you know, how you can score good. So this exam is not based on your craft skill. How was the first exam is not based on only the your drawing skill. This exam is not based on your craft skill. So here he will tell you the step by step what you need to do in the exam so that you can score better. In between, if you have a question, you can raise the hand like me. It will come on the screen. You can type there also.
So we, our expert will help you. And the people who are the day one classes, later on, Rimjim ma'am and me, we will guide you, we'll help you about all this. And whatever questions you have, you can ask later on. Or one more thing is very important. It's a day one. It's just we have added you to get friendly on this Zoom platform, because maybe a few of you are using the first time. So later on in our messages, you can give us the, like, you know, your comment. Meanwhile, if any one of you want to show your work and you can take the feedback from our expert and us, that also you can do it. So yeah, that's it from my side.
Okay, Ayan, can you hear us?
Yeah. Sorry for the internet.
No, that's fine, Ayan sir. You can continue now.
Yeah, sure. So, hello everyone. I hope all of you are doing good in, like, even in this sort of situation where all of us are doing online classes. And apart from that, see, first thing first, you need to understand what exactly is to be done in the next step. Okay. See, especially in NIFT, for the situation test, they are not going to see only where, what exactly you are good at, also how you the product that you're gonna make. Okay, so these are the major three things that we are gonna discuss. So are you guys ready? So before that, I want everyone to be more interactive. So, if I'm talking, then you need to, if you're not able to understand, you can ask me any question in between. And also, like, if you have any sort of query, then I guess someone's mic is on. So yeah, apart from that, if you have any sort of question or anything, then let me know. Hey, so I'll start with my introduction. I am as Krishna said, so I've done product design and then industrial design, now working as a UX designer. But that was possible just because of I was able to understand how exactly I need to put my understanding in terms of design, in terms of execution, in terms of communication. So now when you are getting into the design field, you need to understand these three skill set. Okay, not only the execution, not only the communication, not only the process, but all the three things you need to combine all together, and you need to best out of it. So I'll start with just one second. Okay. Okay. So guys, I don't know, like, many of you are very new to this class. So, like, I'll share a few of the techniques paper. If you one thing is for sure, ki the quality at the end of the day, you're gonna showcase the execution, this thing that helps a lot the other person to understand what exactly and how much understanding of any material that you have. Also, how much clarity that you have in terms of understanding level. Okay, what exactly used to be done and they were asked you to do, and also how the process, how exactly you have defined each and every process on the basis of the question. Okay, so first of all, we need to understand. Rimshi ma'am, I'm just asking, the rest people, like the student, they done with the basic level, right?
Yes.
Paper model making and other stuff.
Yeah, they have just done paper craft and all, and few are new. So it's their first class, but for few, they have explored only paper as of now. Newspaper and chart paper and thin and thick papers. That's it.
Okay, cool. So guys, I will start with the design process. Okay, so stay with me. Be interactive. If you don't understand, then let me know. If you understand, just give me signs so that I can understand that you all of you have understood. So first of all, first thing first, you need to be very positive, because all of you need just one single seat for you, right? Like, you don't have to worry for others how they good, they are doing good in their life, they are good doing good in their areas, okay? But unless and until positively or mentally, if you're not active and if you're not able to understand what exactly is to be done, you won't be able to execute on the basis of your level, okay? So now the first thing comes, be positive. Second thing, understand what the question is all about. Second, you need to follow some sort of process where exactly follow design process. It's very simple. You don't have to worry like what is design process, like you don't need to take too much of pressure like on this. Apart from then, write-ups, how you need to write write-ups, especially about the write-ups, Krishna sir is going to talk more about on that. So let's start with the for all the other students who are old, they need to understand this. Also for the new student, so I'll just brief out the entire design process.
Hang on, how you one need second. To start. Surbhi has raised a hand. Surbhi, you can unmute yourself and ask a question. Surbhi, can you hear us? Okay, Ayan, you can continue.
Yeah. So, guys, first of all, as soon as you see the question, that matters a lot. Like when you are starting with the question, all of you get confused. What sort of question? Which question you need to attempt? Okay. So, understand the question that somebody is actually. Okay. So somebody is not clear how to pick the question. You need to read all the questions first. Don't jump directly that this question I want to solve. Read all the questions. So as soon as you are done with like, okay, this is the final question that I'm going to attempt. Cool, done with that. Then do the brainstorming on that. Do the mind mapping. Let's say if you are taking any sort of question related to making posters for coronavirus, let's say the very fresh topic coronavirus, or let's say any topic related to child labor or you need to do some sort of brainstorming, some sort of mind mapping where exactly you'll be writing all the keywords related to that area. Let's say I'm taking coronavirus. Okay, so if coronavirus is there, so execution is one thing. Before that, you need to understand how you're gonna take ahead with that topic. So as soon as you writing your topic in the center, you need to write all those related key elements. Let's say coronavirus spread through person to person. Okay, it spread with the connecting getting in touch with other person and all and all and all. So also this is a virus. Okay, so I think this is a very good topic to start with. So write all those related lines or related keywords so that you'll be able to make the loop where exactly you can able to pick. Let's say virus, that is one keyword. Touch, keeping yourself detached with social, like you should not be getting in touch with anybody or any people around you. So you as soon as you are done with that, and don't restrict yourself ki ha this much is enough. Do as much as you can, but same time you need to be very aware about the timings, the time that you're taking. Okay, so first we started with the, attempting the question, then doing the mind map. Now question comes, what next? So you'll be taking 10 different top key elements. Let's say if I'm taking coronavirus, so I'll take virus, I'll take hand sanitizing, I'll take related to those most 10 keywords which can help you to execute something out of it. Are you guys able to understand some sort of action? I'm not able to see.
Yeah,
are you
yeah, sir.
Sure? Just give me some action. Okay. So as soon as you picked 10, okay. So again, you'll be confused. Okay. After taking 10 different keywords, how exactly I can, make something out of it. Now the time comes where exactly you need to make the correlation between those elements, coronavirus itself, hand sanitizing, social distancing, and all those things, right? So after that, once you have combined these key elements, you're gonna make concept out of it. Now this thing comes that you need to start making story on the basis of that. So if you have taken coronavirus itself, social distancing, and all these things, so now create some sort of story out of it. How you can create personas, like not persona, but story out of it. So when you are done with that story telling also, you need to also starting visualizing at the same time. Means if I need to make a virus shape, then that is one thing. Hand, that is one thing. So I'm just giving you example. It can be anything. It's not restricting that what I'm saying, you guys need to do the same. It's just that you need to understand same time what are the key elements that can be executed. Okay. Once you are done with that, now it comes to the write up. So first of all, don't take much time, in terms of design process, in terms of write up. So 15 minutes, and also don't just jump in the question. Don't jump directly into execution. Do this because entire class will be doing the same, mistakes, that as soon as they see the question, they jump and start executing. And that's where you will be, at the good, positive side. Means you are trying to, make the story out of it instead of just jumping on the, see, even you can do that as well, but that is called reverse engineering, which will not help you to communicate your ideas very well. You will be able to communicate, but that will not help you to communicate what exactly you want to tell. Okay. Then as soon as you are done with your process and the storytelling, now it comes to execution level. So later on, as soon as you start with the model making, now you need to understand the strength of different material. So the practice of the different sort of material that we are doing, that is very much important. So don't skip classes. Don't assume that if I will not do this, it will happen. No, any sort of material will help you. Exploring all the material will help you in that particular situation when you are in the class, when you are in the examination hall. So try to explore as much as different material you can. Even it can be, very flimsy paper. It can be 300 or 500 GSM paper or anything. So because you never know what sort of material that you're gonna get out there, right? Then you'll be creating. Then you'll be writing the entire concept. Okay, what exactly you took? Why exactly you took? Because the this is the chain reaction happening in the scenario right now, and this is how you can give some sort of solution. Now when you are done with your execution, even after that, you need to understand how you are making the entire scenario. Means if you have created virus shape, hand shape, or anything, you need to combine all those things together and represent such a way so that any person, anyone who's coming to see your work or who's going to judge and give the marks to you, they will be able to understand your ideas very quick. Don't make things very, you know, meshy. Try to make it very simple, very neat and clean. Also, don't try that if you have done something that is communicating enough, that is enough. You don't have to report at the end of the examination time ki, I missed this. Don't. Even if you have missed it, leave it there, because that will mess your model at that point of time. Okay, now things come as I said ki, the entire composition making means if you have organized in a such a way so the person can see and understand things very well, that is more than enough. Also, if you can showcase your design process with the other sheet, like the write-up that you're going to write, just keep the design process paper there only, so that the person can understand what are the process that you have done with that. Okay, because not everyone is going to do the same. So that was the part of design process. Very simple process, but yeah, this will be effective for your model making and other thing all together. So yeah, Rinju ma'am, this was the entire process from my side for the especially starting the choosing the question and coming to the execution level.
Yeah, so this was like, you know, how you can take it forward from here. So if you guys have any questions, because I answer having experience of, yeah, a few of you have joined later on. So I will just again introduce him. He is from IIT Bombay. He's completed his master from IIT Bombay and BDS from Product and Lifestyle Accessories from NIFT Bangalore. And right now, what is your profile, I answer?
I'm a UX Hello? Designer.
Yeah. Right now he's a UX designer. So very valuable points he has told you guys. So this exam is not based on craft. Many of you keep asking me. So they are not going to judge your craft skill. Govind sir also said yesterday. So you need to take care of what? Your concept, idea, and all these things. And obviously, we'll practice a couple of your question paper and other things also. Meanwhile, I would like to explain you the one thing over here. What kind of question normally they ask? Let's segregate these questions. Rimji ma'am will give you the example of it also. The question may come in form of trophy. It can be a mascot. It can be a composition. It can be a product in 3D, which normally we practice. Few of you have already attended few classes. You have learned few techniques. We will again come for new student, the technique classes, which will teach you live in a live session. But today the idea is, if we will synchronize our entire topic, so they're going to ask the question is only in 5 form. I remember once they have asked to design a T-shirt. It's something in 2012, if I'm not wrong. Yes, I answered. Yeah. 2012 or 11?
Yes, 12.
Yeah, so you have to design a T-shirt, and that T-shirt should have some, and it's not a poster or composition, a poster design. This is the situation test question I'm telling you. Design a T-shirt which have a message. Like, suppose you can make a T-shirt, this have a message of awareness towards the coronavirus, stay in home or something like this. So very interesting type of the question they ask normally. So we will see today, the Rimji ma'am will show you right now a couple of examples on the screen she will share, so that will be visible for everybody. So idea of today's class to give you, you need to work for your basic. Fundamental is our 3D exploration, learning of the material, handling the material, which we have discussed in last class. Today we are discussing about how we'll conceptualize and we'll concrete to get the better marks. Because our exam is for 100 marks, where 30 marks is for write-up, and the write-up marks having a very great relation with your product also. Because if you don't write properly, it will not sync with your product. You may not get, even though if your product may look good, but you may get a lesser mark, because that's happened with us during the NIFT, during the 8th semester. I do remember sometime we have done a very excellent product and we feel like we may get out of 20, because normally in NIFT, you may have 5, 10 and 20 marks exercises and the submissions. You remember, we think, we may get out of 20, 18 or 17, 19, and we end up with getting 16 or 17 or 14. Do you remember, Rimji ma'am? Kind of some. Yes. So if you really want good marks, really work for all this, what I answers has here today, it is very, very important, guys. This obviously will explore all this exploration, material handling. We'll complete making it in within a time, but this is very essential. And we will come for a write-up also, but that is a later on stage. Right now, it's not. So, Rimji ma'am, would you like to share some of the images and references for all this? An example that, as we discussed?
Yes, before that, there are a few questions that students have asked for you.
Yeah, please.
The question student, you can answer?
Sure. Okay, the first question is?
First question is, give some clue on what type of questions are asked.
Yeah. So I have just now as explained you, we can derive your question rather than 15, 18, 16 year in five category. Composition, maybe the memento. It, see, the basic memento you can make, then you, it can be a Corona, World Cup, Olympic or something else. But the memento is there, right? Same way, they may ask you the, like I have told you something, piece of design and all that category. Daily lifestyle product, it may be a bag or some other accessories you can think that may come. So like that, we have a five category. One by one, each category we'll attempt. We will try in a particular time limit. So that's what the answer of that question. Already we have discussed.
Another question is, how much should it take to write a write-up? How much time I think it should take to write a write-up?
Yes. So write-up part will come later on in the practice. So, but write-up is very important. Now you can write in a keywords. Your write-up keywords you can write now. Write-up is very, very important. That also I have discussed right now, how important it is, what is the marking for the write-up, because 3 to 4 people is going to check your paper in the exam. One is the internal faculty of that particular center. One is the faculty from external center. One is the industry expert is compulsory. Okay. So it is very important to have a very good write-up, because first they start reading your write-up. You may think, okay, they will come and see your product. No, that's just a, like, you know, same. They will read your write-up and they will try to sync with your concepts. Yeah, okay. Next question.
Abhijit has asked if his English is not good, how to enhance doing the write-up?
Doesn't matter, Abhijit. I am from Patna. I brought up there and I have learned step by step. I will tell you in person. We will have a custom classes also in between. We'll have 4 to 5 students in a group. Maybe somebody having a problem in material handling. Somebody may have a problem to doing a write-up. We will help you individually basis how to improve your write-up. Right now, the best way is to buy some, you cannot buy it. So find out the some magazine which you have in a home and see the words which they are writing it in their, like, you know, product experience or product detail. There they write some keywords and all, which is very important. Those words you can use it. Anyway, we'll discuss in a detail.
Abhijit, I'll add with Abhijit's question. So write-up is one thing. Again, I said, as I said, process that you're gonna, use, you can, as soon as you'll put that in the, with addition to your model, that will help the other person to understand what exactly you have done. So that will also make help. Otherwise, anyways, we are gonna, make you guys to understand one by one down the line.
Yeah.
Okay. For Arya, material handling sessions for the new students will happen again. This is the expert session. We will be continuing the material handling sessions as well. Harshad, I will upload some examples of write-up in the group so that it helps. Usually, it should take 10 to 15 minutes. So, I hope that is cleared. Now, what I will do is... first, what I want is we'll take one topic, which is like mascot. So, Pramod has asked one more question. Is it important to make a model functional? It's better if you make the model functional and we'll move on to the functional topic or how to make craft functional or 3D models function later on. But yes, that's an important point as well. Okay, so today we'll do mascots. So usually you must have learned mascots for the first round of your test in CAT. So sometimes mascots come, like, you know, create a 3D model or situation for some topic like child labor or coronavirus or anything which is given. So mascot usually is a personified object. You must have seen like that McDonald's. There is that guy who is always outside, that McDonald's guy in yellow and red. There is in Olympics, you must have seen those mascots of animals or objects which are personified. I'll be sharing a screen right now with you all so that you all can see it. I hope you can see this. Wait, one second. Yeah. So see this. So this is a mascot. Yeah, this was a mascot for Olympics. So I am very sure if we need to make it in 3D, we will use paper and try to add elements like, you know, the logo is there. The description of the object is there. Like I told you about McDonald's, you know, those that egg which is made. One second. Yes, this one. So that McDonald guy is a mascot. This is a mascot of an animal which is personified. And when you look at it, it should represent the topic. Or, you know, suppose this was for, I think, Olympics or Rio de Janeiro, some Olympics this was for. So it represents something. This is for the rugby or the soccer games. So, you know, it's usually animals or usually personified objects, or you take elements together and bring them together in a composition and then try to represent, so that a person doesn't have to explain it. Once you see it, you know that, okay, this represents coronavirus, or this represents child labor, this represents climate change. That's how we do mascots. You can see that elephant and lion one for the railways that we have seen a lot. Okay. So today what I want you to do as homework is make a mascot on coronavirus, okay? So I have gathered few pictures of few elements that you can use, okay? So one is, of course, like Ayan sir was telling, you need to brainstorm and write the elements and see how you can bring them together. So first is this virus shape. So I am sure you can make this virus shape from paper, from using toothpicks in a sphere ball. You can use paper and stack things. You can see this one also, how they have used threads and try to make a virus. I have these kind of paper drawings also that I could find on internet to show you an example. This can be one element, the virus shape itself. The other element can be, you know, a world map or a world, or, you know, flights or lockdown. It can also be like this, where, you know, you are locked in your houses and you are trying to make something. Then another element which is important is the mask. So you can create a mask from paper folding, from fringing. And I think these elements are very easy to make. It won't take you long, I think, more than 10 minutes to make element and then draw the sketches and put them together. You know, some creative viruses, maybe like this, which has, you know, or have a theme. This is also like, you know, how you can make that virus in that time. I got this image also of one of the mascots that I was looking for. So I think this is also something that we can look into. So again, what are the elements of a mascot? It's the shape. It can be a personified or, you know, exaggerated view of something. I'll show you these examples and I'll post this on group again, where you can take inspiration from these things, which elements I am showing you. One second. So I'll come back to this. First thing is you do a sketch, or you do brainstorming. You do the brainstorming that, yes, my topic for today is coronavirus. The 10 things that elements that come out of it are lockdown, virus, it's contagious, mask, we don't have groceries, food, which whatever things you can think about. Out of that, you think the second thing you need to think about is you need to make a you need to filter out things that are easy for you to make. Okay, I can make a mask, but I can't make a human body. So rather than that, I'll make a earth or a globe on which I will show that. So that will be filtering. Now, after that, you do a write-up. You do at least 3 sketches of it and you spend 15 minutes on this process and you start, you know, having your compositions together. Like, okay, earth is below and the virus is over. The mask, earth is wearing a mask maybe. So these kind of ideations you do and you take 1.5 hours for this. Now you will be left with 30 minutes. In those 30 minutes, try to finish any changes or anything and put a timer when you do this exercise. So people who are new with us, you know, we will show you material handling and all these things in the next class for paper and all. You can personally message me or message Krishna sir and we'll tell you how to go about it. And this will be the homework for the next class. I have few questions in the chat coming up.
answer them because few of them has really joined late.
Yes, for everyone you need to make a mascot. Mascot, I have explained you, it's a personified object, and you need to make a mascot for coronavirus. So Ayushi and Devyani, that's the question. Ayushi has asked, okay, that's the question. Arya, mascot making means justice structure. Should you need to organize it all together, Arya. So you need to organize and make a composition. It can't be hanging in the air, right? It will have a base. It will have a background. So like you used to sketch your things in your CAD paper, in situation test, you just make it 3D. That's it. That's how you do it. Instead of making a human, you make the human in 3D. You make a globe in 3D. So that's how it is. Anyone else who has any questions regarding this?
Richa has asked you something, please check.
Yeah, we can add any element we know or related to that topic. Of course, the elements that you add in mascot should be relatable. Even if it's a different, maybe it's butterflies that you are adding to this topic, but it should have a reason why you are adding it. Maybe for better world, you are adding butterflies and it's hanging on the top or something, but you need to write that down in your write-up. So I need write-up, I need sketches, I need the model. These are the three things I need so that we can use only paper. We have done only paper. You have newspapers, try that. Try coloring if you want. For now, can we add captions and taglines, Rachel? Yes, but they should be in block 3D letters, you know, 3D letters. Yes. I've taught you 3D letters.
Yeah, so should be. Could I conclude? We'll close this session.
Yes.
Yeah. So, guys, one more important point. Like, put the timer when you starting your topic, because it is very much important. Because if you'll start the practicing with the time as well, it will help you at the end of the before the exam. Because see. Most of the people are at home. You might be get stuck or going somewhere in the middle of the this thing somewhere, so that don't do that. But whenever you are sitting, just start with timing and make sure like you all also try to sketch something, so that will create add-ons for that. Krishna sir.
Yes. Yeah, well, thank you so much, Ayan. Ayan sir is here. He is alumni of IIT Bombay. Rimji ma'am was here. He's a product designer and product accessory lifestyle designer from NIFT Bangalore. Nidhi ma'am was here in the session from Pune. And many of you have joined us across the India.
Harshad is asking something.
So Rimji ma'am, or we will answer you personally of your questions. Now, whatever you have. Guys, if you are new, you have just joined for a first class, go and check our Ignite India channel. There are a couple of other examples of the videos I have also uploaded.
There are a lot of things you have read from paper.
Yes, so you will get So you will get the idea about our online classes also. It's just a glimpse of our class. That's it from our side. Okay, for more detail, contact Rimji ma'am or contact me. I'm Krishna here.
Yes.
And we'll guide you how you can continue with us. Thank you so much, everyone.
About homework, next class, your doubts, it will be provided on the group. These are sessions right now which are going on through Ignite India. You can find them on YouTube as well. Okay. Richa has asked again, can we add anything which will happen in the topic, in that topic in future? Yes, it's your representation. You can add anything you like. There's no
just do it, but how guys, you communicate that is also how exactly you are communicating the same thing that is also gonna make difference. So try to communicate the same thing in the write-up as well as entire storytelling.
Okay, thank you everyone. Rimji ma'am.
Yes, so there are few students who have not been added to the group. We'll add you to the group.
We will. You discuss with individual person whomsoever is in your contact. Either me, Krishna, or Rimjim. I think both of your both of us is calling.
We have one more question. Yeah. Ask.
Richa.
Right now, only paper. I have told everyone to use only paper, nothing else. Only paper. We will explore only paper, newspaper, glazed paper, part paper, only paper. That's it. Okay?
If most of you are looking a bit blank, don't worry. The